Hi, it's Karina Gordon-Barnes of youinspireme.co.uk. And today we're talking about niche. So if you're one of those people who, and this is very, very normal, who resists picking a niche for your business, you're like, no, I don't want to narrow down, then here's an analogy, a comparison that might be really helpful. So I'm going to use an example from the UK education system. So just translate it if you're in a different country or in a different system. So in the UK, when kids get to secondary school, they will choose GCSE options. So whether they choose like 10, 11, 12, 8, however many subjects they choose at GCSE, they're already starting to like narrow down their choices of subjects that they're interested in. So from the very, very vast range of school subjects that you can possibly study, it's like, okay, here are 10 that I really want to focus on. So they start getting a bit more defined, a bit more clear on their area of interest and strength and passion. And then when they get then to the next level, up into maybe sixth form, they choose their AS levels that they take, so maybe 5 AS levels. And then they then drop down to say 3 or 4 A levels. If this is the route they're taking, I'm just going to use this one example. I know there are many, many other options people can take through the education system. But so each time they've got their subjects and then they're going to the next level of getting clear and getting specific. And then, of course, if they go to university, they'll choose maybe one subject that they'll study at university. So you could think about niche like this, like you're continually getting clearer and clearer about your areas of most passion and most interest. What's also really interesting about this analogy is that nothing is set in stone. You know, one of my best friends did art, history of art at university, and is now doing a PhD in geography, something completely different about the environment and sustainability, completely different from anything to do with art. I know another friend who did a degree in history, who then did a conversion course to law. So nothing's set in stone. You can change your mind at any point in the education world, just as you can change your mind when it comes to niche. But maybe think of it like this, like you're getting continually more defined and you're specialising more and more. So if we take the example of niche, it might be that you start with a case I want to work with women. Okay, women are still a very broad group, but let's say that's like choosing your GCSEs. You're still staying quite broad and general. And then you say, actually, it's women who are mothers. So you're getting into the kind of AS level of definition. Right, women who are mothers, and then women who are mothers who, etc. And you go further and further and you get more and more defined. And yeah, you can change your mind at some point. But rather than just thinking, I've got to choose a niche, I think this might help you to think about it as continually refining and continually honing, developing your area of specialty. So if this video has been helpful for you, please share this with other people that you think it will be helpful for. Share it on social media, share it by email. And come over to youinspireme.co.uk to get more tips and strategies for running a successful, happy and profitable business. This is Karina Gordon-Barnes of youinspireme.co.uk.